Hello, I'm Josh Carr, and today I'd like to talk to you about how you should be using conditional formatting. And also, if you enjoy this sort of content, I do teach classes on Excel for Real Estate Analysis every few weeks. You can attend in person in New York City or over Zoom, depending on your preference. If you'd like to read more about my classes or sign up, please check out my website at kahrrealestate.com or carrrealestate.com. Cool. So here's a little hack I use in model building. So first off, there's a thing in Excel called conditional formatting, and frankly, most people are using it incorrectly. Most people will have some numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then they'll do conditional formatting, and they'll decide, hey, I'm going to put some colors on this thing. Like, I'm going to put on some data bars so the big numbers have big values, or I'm going to put like some check boxes or arrows on this thing, or, you know, cell phone bars. And I mean, you can do that, but like, that's not really helpful. I've never found a model that had cell phone bars on it and thought to myself, thank heavens, now I can figure out what the model is doing. This is how I like to use it. Let's say you have a project management schedule and you've got like start dates and end dates or something like that. In each of these cells, I have a formula. In this case, it's comparing the start date to the month we're in and the end date to the month we're in. And of course, if both things are true, this evaluates as true because, well, that's the way Excel works. If I make this, say, 5, and I make that like 9, or I make that like 4, and I make that like 8, you can see the colors moving around. It's a flexible schedule. Now, how is that working? Here's how. You can see that there's a formula in each of these cells. Of course, in this case, it's kind of like grayed out. But if I go to conditional formatting under the Home tab, we can see that I put in some coloring to say, if it's true, make it green. If it's false, make it white. And if I look at, say, the green one, and the format, what it's doing here is it's saying make the backdrop green and also make the text green. In other words, it's, you know, green on green. That's why you're not seeing the trues and falses there written out. It's basically green on green or white on white. So it just kind of disappears. And again, this works pretty well. In fact, you could use it other ways. If I have these color codes, I could change them and the colors change. And in this case, I have a formula that says, do the true function. If it's true, put in a code 1, 2, or 3. And then if I look at conditional formatting on, say, this cell here, we can see that I said, if it's false, make it white. That is to say, if it's not in the zone, make it white. Whereas if it's 1, make it green, if it's 2, make it yellow, if it's 3, make it red, you get the idea. Finally, I could use this if I had, say, like a floor plan or a stack plan. If you can imagine that this is, say, the floor plan of a building, maybe you have different colors tied to, like, is the unit above market, is it below market, is it a free market apartment, is it a rent-controlled apartment, I don't know. Look, I don't draw pictures. I'm not an artist by any means, but I can definitely lay out lines on Excel. And if I wanted to have some sort of like Excel-driven artwork, I guess this is a way you could do it. And again, you could do like, you know, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, and now all the colors change. So there you go. You want to build floor plans. You want to do a visual representation in the building of where tenants are, maybe vertically, like a stack plan. You want to have a project management schedule. That's how I'd use conditional formatting. And I would stop using it for things that are frankly foolish, like, say, putting cell phone bars on numbers. I don't really see how that helps anyone. Anyway, hopefully you found that helpful. If you did, great. If you didn't, feel free to drop me an email and tell me what you'd like to see that would help you be helpful. Help me be helpful, that is. And until I see you again, keep building better models. Thanks.